Hi everyone, in this installment of Skookum Robotics setup and troubleshooting videos, we're going to have a look at the self-level features of the SK720. Before you turn on self-leveling, it's important to make sure that your heli's vibrations are low. The SK720's gyro sensors used for normal flight are very resistant to vibrations, but the accelerometers used for self-leveling are more vibration sensitive. To check your heli's vibration level, hover a few times with one cyclic bank set for self-level and one set with self-level turned off. Hover with self-level turned off, and after each flight, check the SK720's LED. If it shows green with a red flicker, this is the vibration alarm. This indicates that the vibration level is too high for self-level. You can also record a playback log and check the vibe score. It should be less than 5.0. If your vibes are high, record a vibration log to help find the cause, or mount the SK720 on a metal plate. Proper mounting is key when keeping the vibrations low for self-leveling. The SK720 should never contact the frame. The anti-vibration kit included with the SK720 is an easy way of doing this. Wires or cables should be loose for the few centimeters leading into the SK720, and helis larger than 500 size should use the power bus to isolate the SK720. Make sure your canopy doesn't rattle against the helicopter's frame, and make sure that mechanical factors like straight tail shafts and undamaged blades are in order. The percentage you set your self-level to represents the amount of control rate available to the SK720 when self-leveling. For example, if you've left your control rate to the default setting of 240 degrees per second and set your self-level to 100%, the SK720 will attempt to level your heli at a max rate of 240 degrees per second. Typically, you'll set your self-level percentage to 100% when using self-level to allow the feature to function at its full potential. It's important to remember, you can set two banks of self-level settings and switch between them using the same channel as your cyclic gains. This will allow you to change between two different self-level settings while flying, depending on how you need the self-level to work at a given moment. There are four settings for self-leveling: always on, center stick, always on and inverted, and center stick and inverted. Setting your self-level to always on will have your SK720 constantly try to keep your heli level. This is a good setting to use if you're new to flying or if you're being cautious, but it will make a lot of aerobatic maneuvers impossible since the SK720 will work against the pilot's controls to keep the heli level. Looking at the center stick setting, this is often used by most pilots as a bailout option. When you've lost control of your heli or lost orientation, let go of the cyclic stick to activate the self-level. This setting is best used with a high percentage setting, so the SK720 will bail your heli out as quickly as possible. Other than turning the self-level off, the center stick setting gives you the most control over your heli without the self-level interrupting. There are two inverted settings to the self-level feature: always on and inverted, and center stick and inverted. The inverted settings won't try to flip the heli upside down while you're flying normally, but activate once the heli is within 60 degrees of being inverted. For the center stick setting, the self-level will only activate if you release the stick, both upright and inverted. When you're using the inverted always-on setting, the self-level will work full-time, inverted or not. When flying normally, your heli will fly like a coaxial helicopter. Once it has reached 60 degrees of inverted, the heli will level inverted until the 60-degree threshold is crossed again. Setting one self-level bank to always-on is a good idea if you're uncomfortable trying the other self-level settings. If you don't want to let go of the cyclic stick while trying the center stick setting, or are worried about righting the heli while using either of the inverted settings, you can simply switch to the always-on bank to level your heli out. Finally, you can set your heli to self-level if the SK720 loses signals from your transmitter. At the bottom of the control tab, click Self-Level if Signal Lost if you want to use this function. If you've set the failsafes correctly with a few degrees of negative collective pitch, it should auto-rotate down level. In this brief field demo, you can see the self-level holding the swashplate against the direction of the heli's movement until the heli is level. With self-level turned off, the swashplate does not hold the attempted maneuver, but returns to center regardless of the heli's orientation. This flight demo now shows the characteristics of self-leveling while flying. In normal flybarless flight, the heli would hold the direction it's moving until another control input was given. With self-level set to always on, the heli levels out like a coaxial helicopter and would eventually drift to a stop. That's all for self-leveling. Thanks for watching.